Yes, it's 6:30. Let's start. Okay, we'll step straight. Start with the Guru Vandanam. Nityanandam Paramasukhadam Kevalam Jnanamurtim Dvandvatitam Gaganasadrisham Tattvamasya Vilakshyam Ekam Nityam Vimalamachalam Sarvadi Sakshibhutam Bhavatitam Tripunarahitam Sadgurum Tam Namami. Nityanandam, welcome to Kailash Courtyard Manifesting Power Session. This is a wonderful session that Swamiji has created, the Kailash Courtyard, for all the God and Goddesses to come every day and manifest different powers of Sadashiva, living the space, state, and manifesting powers of Sadashiva, Paramashiva. The beautiful space that Swamiji has given us and taking us every day one step closer and closer to the ultimate reality. Here, we were discussing yesterday about the elements, five elements, and how the five states, how we understand each element and how it maps into our different length, breadth, dimensions that we are. Once we understand this more clearly, the whole words, the verbalization will start just withering away. So many questions yesterday. It was very interesting. Literally, it was how I used to work with the Gurukul Balasans. They, just before the Vakya Sadas, Joyce Ma will post you the link of Vakya Sadas. We have 126 episodes of Vakya Sadas of Balasans. What is Vakya Sadas? It is debate, but it is deeper than debate. It is taking each other into the deeper cognition. How you can make other person go deeper into more deeper cognition. If you take me to deeper cognition, then you have to listen to me. I take you to the deeper cognition, then I have to listen to you. It's a very beautiful way of debating. And it is not for and against like a usual debate, but it is going deeper and deeper. Who takes more deeper? So we have this link. We have loaded all the Vakya Sadas. Usually we use it for training material. It is so intense that these kids are exploring all these higher truths in the very young age. So here Swamiji maps the five element into the five dimension. How he maps? So we have the length, breadth, depth, and then we have the time and space. So we know the five dimensions. Then we know the five elements. We know the earth element, which is mapped to the length. We know the next, the breath, which is the liquid water element. Next is the cognition, the depth is the fire element. Next is the time, the breath, which connects the gross to the subtle. That is why the breath connects to the subtler and subtler and subtler, to the space component, which is the ether. If we understand these, how it is all working, how Sadashiva's Akshaya Guna works, the inner, we all understand how mind works. We know how is the intellect and mind, and how we use the mind in the correct, get the high IQ, study well, memorize, concentrate, all these things. But now we are consciousness. We know we are consciousness. We are energy, not matter. How to understand I am energy? How do I cognize I am energy? Whether is it cognition or what it is? All these questions keep coming to us. Yesterday we were trying to map it and understand. I want to go to the deeper. We understood that we are the subtle consciousness, the matter, either the body or you call it even the coconut. How the coconut moves, the first thing Swamiji teaches is consciousness over matter. So the energy can move something which is a solid matter. That is the first lesson he gives us. That is why the coconut moves. Same way, Swamiji says, this energy, consciousness, is creating even our body. We are looking from the body. Length, breadth, depth is where we live. And we are looking at the consciousness. Oh, I have some powers. Instead, Swamiji asks you to shift from that cognition, little bit 360 degrees, that consciousness is creating the matter. That's all we need to do. We understand that we are human and there is some part of us which happens when we connect to Swamiji as divine. Instead, Swamiji very clearly says that is a lie. You are divine beings having the human component. If we start living that, we will start understanding the whole science what Swamiji gives us. The Akshaya Guna, the all-pervading, all omnipresent, infinite. These are the words which are defining consciousness. It is there in everything. Whether if we take a rose, it is not the word rose. It is not the perfume. It is not the color. It is not the smell. But it is energy. From energy, it is created as a rose in front of us. So when we understand that energy is creating matter, we got it. We are only seeing that energy has the matter has energy. That's how we view it right now. Everything has energy. Yes, yes. I also have consciousness because I am alive. You also have consciousness because you are alive. No. And the consciousness is creating us even now. We are living in the body. We have to live with the understanding that I exist as a witness. I exist as a reflection. Swamiji beautifully says one line. I am also reflecting in the form that I exist. What word he uses? I also reflect in the form that he exists. So he is reflecting in the form for us to get connected to have the oneness with him. Because we don't know what is formless. We say energy. How do we understand that? So we need a form for understanding this energy also. So he creates his body as a form so we can get connected in the oneness space. And he's actually, more and more we get connected to that form, we understand it is formless. There is no form at all. Including when people hugged him have realized that it is empty. Many people have reported that he is empty. So once we are formless, when we are energy, we will start seeing everybody as energy. What is that is we see in everybody. That is the natural space. So when we are energy, Swamiji says, when he sits in the satsang, he says, you are like in a screen, you are separate and the scene is separate. For me, everything happens on one screen as an energy. The energy is thrown and creating all these things which are happening. That's all I see. I see kids' energy as immature energy, adults' energy as a matured and blocked and all those things. He just sees as energy. He does not see us as we see, we perceive. We perceive, we want a form, we want something as length, breadth and depth. That is where we are so stuck. Ferociously awaken us to the ultimate space of oneness, which is just pure energy. That is why the length, we understand length, we understand breadth, we know that gross earth element, then we know water element, then we know the next element start becoming subtler, which is fire, the cognition, the fire-ness. The next element is the breath, the air. Air is like a bridge, because till this we know everything. The minute is which is air, which is not something we see, but we know air is there because we are breathing. So the breath is like a bridge between the consciousness and the body. It is like a bridge. It connects both. So he says, just be in the breath of listening in the breath, which will take you to the energy space. If you're constantly with the breath, we are breathing in and breathing out, we will catch it, and the gap between that The breath itself is the conscious space. We'll just land up. It will just take us. So that becomes the path to get into the etheric space, the consciousness. Once we understand we are consciousness, that's all. We are unlimited. We are all pervading. We are infinite. We can create our body in any way we want. We can create others' body in any way we want, because infinite is our own energy. Everything starts happening because we are a reflection of Swamiji in this body. We'll start understanding we also are a reflection. We are like a pot which sun is reflecting in the pot of water. We start assuming we are the pot and we are celebrating. No, the pot can break anytime. We are not the pot. That's why death happens anytime. We are not the pot. We are not the water, but the reflection in that. The reflection itself is the whole energy. So if we understand consciousness over matter, we are actually expressing these powers to make us understand, hey, I am consciousness over the matter. I have more control over the matter. Not the matter has more control, the identity which I carry, which the matter has created, the mind has created, always thinks it has more power than me. But when I ferociously decide, I am always having, we know many times in our life we have done it. When emergency comes, we take the ferocious step and we know we have done it. So whenever we took the ferocious step to stand more than the mind and the body, the possibilities of just the mind and body, we have conquered it. Now, without any of the root shock, we can wake us up into the space of oneness of Sadashiva as energy and express as a matter, as a manifest of Swamiji everywhere. That is the most beautiful space that we can start enjoying. He says even the direction towards that will make us realize. Constantly contemplating on that, constantly living that as our pie of Paramashiva. That is my pie of my Paramashiva, that I am Paramashiva. If I start deciding that decision is the Akshaya Guna that I'm going to carry, that is the pie of Paramashiva. Whole thing, my decision to change from body to understanding as I'm divine into I am divine holding the body, as creating my body at my will. That's why he says, future, people will be creating extra hands, not gender change, but extra hands, wings, eyes, extra hair and all kinds of things. How is it possible? Because we are consciousness. We can create anything we want, the way we want. So that is why the gods and goddesses, you see so many hands, so many possibilities to tell us that consciousness over matter. Matter does not have intelligence. The highest, the space dimension, each one is a Devi itself. For example, cognition is Durga Devi. And next is Kalika, the time component, which is mapped to the air component is Kalika. Next is the conscious ether space is, Swamiji beautifully says, Maha Saraswati. That is the intelligence. The when you surrender to the Guru, the energy becomes the intelligence. The ultimate space that you hold is the intelligence itself. So you become the Maha Saraswati, just manifesting whatever creation you want. The ultimate space of oneness. So this is what Swamiji gives us in the Jnanapadhati introduction. Actually, this is the introduction of Jnanapadhati that Swamiji has spoken in the satsang. So that is such a beautiful, it's clicking to us now because we have the listening space to all these dimensions. That is so beautiful. Usually he speaks few years before and then we are trying to catch up with him. So this is the most beautiful. So let's take 5 minutes, write down our understanding as consciousness creating this matter. Whatever we understand as your Akshaya Guna, what you understand, how you want to exist, as consciousness over matter. Instead of matter holding the consciousness, we are going to hold consciousness over matter. That's the best click. Because once we are consciousness, none of our pattern even matter. None of the pattern really matters for us. Because we know we are consciousness. I am going to create. Hey, what are you telling me about your patterns? First, the body itself I'm going to create. Then you're talking about the mind on the body. You will be very clear that I am consciousness. What are you talking about? Patterns. It is like you're talking about a dress. Hey, I first will create the body, then you put the dress. It's like that. Pattern is after that. The body is created. So you're going to even create the body. What about the patterns which are troubling you? So be into the space. How you want to live. How you want to live as divine God and goddesses. Be very clear on the consciousness as your core space. So take 5 minutes. Write down consciousness over matter. How is that? What are the Akshaya Gunas that Swamiji has described? The powerful cognitions, the Paramashiva attributes. I am all pervading. I am infinite. I am omnipresent. All these things becomes your reality, existential reality. That is only existential reality. Right now, what we are living is nothing but the same wax, Swami says, which is in the dream. So constantly we are only living in this body, which is causing all this confusion. So let's get to where we belong. So let's take 5 minutes, write down, and then we'll go to the sutra. If you have any questions, please keep posting here in the chat. We'll answer the questions. Yes, we can have the mark here.
Paramashiva.
Yes, Mantras, you can have the sutra. This sutra will answer a lot of questions also. So we'll go through the sutra.
Nadi samhara bhuta jaya bhuta kaivalya bhuta prathaktavani nadi samhara bhuta jaya bhuta kaivalya bhuta prathaktavani.
Okay. Here Swamiji gives a great translation. The merging or absorption of the movement of breathing, nadi samhara, the whole movement of the breath, achieving power over gross element from earth to ether, all earth, water, fire, air and ether, that is called bhuta jaya. Achieving power over the gross element, diverting attention of the mind from all objective senses, that five senses which perceives the gross elements, diverting the attention of the mind from all objective senses, directing it towards the center of the movement of the breath. If we just be with the breath, then it takes and separates your consciousness from the grip of these elementary fields. The elementary field, the gross field, we can get it separated when we observe the breath. That is why breathing is like a bridge. When we start continuously holding the awareness, the witness, the listening of the consciousness, the breath constantly goes in and out, connects to it, right? So the prana, the consciousness itself, we start discovering the whole consciousness. The whole sutra, again, I'm going to read. The merging or absorption of the movement of breathing, achieving power over gross elements from earth to ether, diverting of the mind from all objective senses and directing it towards the center of the movement of the breath, and taking and separating your consciousness from the grip of the elementary field. So here Swamiji gives a very clear method, very clear context, how we can start understanding we are consciousness over matter. He gives the beautiful mapping of all the gross for length, breadth and depth, how the air element, really the time component, which connects to the gross and the subtle, which goes listening of the consciousness itself. So we understand that oneness of Swamiji, when we just observe the breath and hold the oneness with Swamiji as the ultimate consciousness, and visualize Swamiji in the third eye, we go to manifest the power of increasing or decreasing the temperature of the water. We are going to keep a cup of water and you're going to experience the consciousness, the energy over the matter. Matter is now, today is water. Instead of coconut, we are going to have the water. We are going to increase. If you have a thermometer, you can bring the thermometer also, put it in. Of course, don't make it boil it. It will burst. So get a cup of water and put the thermometer, note the reading, then start increasing or decreasing. However you want the thermometer, I don't know what it will measure. Based on that, you increase or decrease. Then you understand you are the consciousness who can change a element, any element in the field. All these elements, water, air, we have done with the coconut. Now we are going to do with the water. So take a cup of water, put it in front of you. Experientially, you see your consciousness or your matter. You say, you're saying that you're a matter, you that you have a consciousness. Now Swamiji is creating you a consciousness. Experientially, we know that we are consciousness creating that heat energy, creating that subtle, the whole thing, the matter, that water quality changes. So we experientially understand the whole thing. Okay, so let's get a cup of water and a thermometer if possible, or you can just touch and see how it is. If you don't have a thermometer, doesn't matter. At least get a bottle of water or cup of water which you can touch and see if it is room temperature. If it is cold, then we can make it, like, I don't want it to cold because it will become room temperature. Either you can just take some tap water or any water and keep it in front of you. Just be the mind, let it listen to the breath. You connect to Swamiji in oneness. Visualize Swamiji in the third eye and connect to Swamiji in oneness, the form that we know of. Continuously, we holding that Mahavakya, constantly chanting and seeing our breath, holding Swamiji inside, will take us consciousness over matter. So physically, let's demonstrate today consciousness, that we are consciousness. We have all, we don't have to live as matter. So let's start with Mahavakya and then Nithyananda Paramashivam. Om 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 Nithyananda Paramashivam.
Nithyananda Paramashivam. Shivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivam Om Nityananda Paramashivam Om Nityananda Paramashivam
Om Nithyananda
Nithyananda Paramashivam Om 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 Nithyananda Paramashivam Nithyananda Paramashivam Om 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 Nithyananda Paramashivam Nithyananda Paramashivam Om 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 Nithyananda Paramashivam Nithyananda Paramashivam Om 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 Nithyananda Paramashivam Nithyananda Paramashivam Om 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 Nithyananda Paramashivam Shivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivam Om Nityananda Paramashivam
Nithyanandam, can you hear me? Okay, great. Beautiful. So, can you share the experience? Who wants to share the experience first?
I have a share.
Yes, ma, please go ahead.
So, I am amazed. So, I started with the Mahavakya. And oneness with Swami, and became the observer in observing the water. So I asked Swami to manifest through me and increase the temperature of the water. So Swamiji said, put your finger in the water. So I put my finger in the water, and I could feel this energy in the water. So, okay, let's increase the temperature of the water. So then I felt something else happening. So I just went with it. I said, okay, Swami, show me what you want to happen. And I do have photos. And I said, it feels like the water in the cup is decreasing. And at the end of it, I looked and the water had decreased like 2 inches. So it dissipated. Oh my God. Where did it go? Oh my God. I am blown away.
Okay. That's beautiful, man. That's wonderful. That's really beautiful. Please post the pictures.
Yes.
Awesome.
Yes, because I took a before picture. Something told me, take a before picture. And I took an after, and you can just see, because Swamiji actually created bubbles in a certain place so that when I took, now I know, so that when I took the picture, you can actually see the difference in the height of the water. It's amazing.
Yes, Swamiji is always amazing. He gives more than what you want. That's the ultimate. We think one, and he gives us like thousands, and that's where we're blown off.
Yes.
Wonderful. Swamiji, thank you.
Thank you, Swamiji.
Great. Thank you, Ma. Thank you so much. Yes, anybody else would like to share? We never think of these dimensions and what all gets created. That's the most awesome. And thank you for sharing. That's even more better. Sharing this moment of sharing whatever you experience mirrors into all of us. Thank you so much. And becomes your conclusion that how Swamiji is the ultimate consciousness creating constantly these matter for us to experience and enjoy. Wonderful, Ma. Thank you, Ma. Yes, anybody else would like to go? Next, any hot, cold, decrease, increase? I didn't even think of decrease, increase, but okay, new dimensions. Decrease, increase, the hot, cold, and yes, please put it in the chat, whatever you experience, please put it as everyone so that everybody can read it. Yes, I'm getting some messages. Yes, thank you, Ma. Wonderful. Whoever experienced any click, anything you want to share also, please go ahead and share it. That's the ultimate space Swamiji creates for us continuously, for us to experience that we are consciousness. It is happening even now. It is our decision to start living that we are consciousness, creating this whatever reality that we exist in. Yes. Saritama, who else wants to share? Come on, quickly. Kathima, Atmama, Nityatmama, so many great manifestors. Pushkalama, we have not heard you for a long time.
I came on late, so I didn't, didn't even know what we were manifesting, but I am.
Okay.
I am feeling the temperature going up and down right now as we're
okay. One of the sessions somebody told me their temperature has gone down and their temperature is increasing. I said, do it in the cup, not in your body. After that you can do it in your body. I said, you should have measured your body temperature then. I asked only to do it in the cup. But Swamiji, they started doing it in their body and Swamiji started happening in their body itself. Anyway, that's nice. Each one has different experiences. Yes, Ma.
Ma, my
yes,
water.
Go ahead, Ma.
Cold, Ma. I bring the tap water. It's become too cold.
Yes, if you have a thermometer that you measure for the kids, put it in that and see the temperature and put the temperature also, Ma. And put the tap water temperature. You can measure it anytime now also. And
yes.
Put the temperature also. Just take a picture of the temperature, your thermometer. That will be awesome.
Sure, Ma.
Yes, we have. Yes, Ma. Excellent. Kathy Ma is saying 75.7 to 75.9 in thermometer in oneness with Swamiji. Ma, make it more. It should become 79 or 74. Great. It started shifting. Just be with it. It will start getting more. Beautiful. Yes, Ma. Great. So that's so beautiful. Anybody else want to share? Go ahead. Please put the pictures with the temperature in the Kailash courtyard. Whenever anything you put it with as authentic as possible so that nobody gets any self-doubt. Because we are very crazy people of having all the self-doubt. So even after manifesting, we'll get a self-doubt. We love to be in the matter. So let's not create any self-doubt. They just should start clicking with the whole thing and start manifesting the powers once they see your post. So make it as authentic as possible. And thank you, Swamiji. Thank you, everybody, for a wonderful session. This was really one of the best revelations that Madhvait felt. Thank you so much, all of you. And we'll sit straight and with the Purna Mantra. Visualize Swamiji in your third eye. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purna Purnamudashyate Purnasya Purnamataya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Hari Om Tat Tat Sarvam Bhagwan Sri Nityananda Paramashiva Paduka Arpanamastu. Om Nithyanandam. Thank you, Swamiji. Thank you, everybody. See you all tomorrow in the next manifesting power of Sadashiva. Be in the state, space, and manifesting powers of Sadashiva continuously. Thank you, Nithyanandam.
Thank you, Ma.
Thank you, Ma. Thank you, Swamiji.
Thank you, Swamiji. Thank you, Ma.